heed the words he said, but that was yesterday. Gold will turn to gray, and youth will fade away. They'll never care about you, call you old and in the way.
Welcome to another episode of Two Old Men in Chairs. I'm Corrin Strong.
I'm Howard Appel.
So today we're going to do our third video of the day, and we're going to honor Chris Webby, who we picked as 2021 Song of the Year with Raw Thoughts 5. Well, we've only been at this for 2 months in the reaction. Our first reaction was In God We Trust. And for a long time, In God We Trust and Raw Thoughts were in a competition to get the most views. And I was wondering which one was going to get over 1,000 first. And then 2 weeks ago, we dropped the Chris Rock, and that went totally bananas. And we have over 13,000 views on that in 2 weeks. So that's the all-time best by far. But as of today, Howard, Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts 5 was the first of our other songs to go over 1,000 views.
Correct, 4 or 5 years.
So it beat out all the Tom McDonald, all the other songs that we've looked at. So congratulations, Chris, and we hope you have equal success with this next one, which is called MetaFreeverse. The one thing I want to say about Chris, his rap is so tight. I mean, there's not a syllable or a word wasted. Every word counts. So many bars go by per minute. It's almost impossible. We have looked at this song a couple times. This is not a first-time reaction.
And we looked at it up.
And we looked at the lyrics, because there's so much packed into these things.
Yeah, very dense.
Very dense, but very good.
Yeah. Webby. So it's 2022. Another year of this fucking bullshit, huh?
Yeah.
All right, I'll smack you right up out the metaverse. So hit the dirt when I get to work. Try to wrap your mind around it and your head'll burst. Got them cell block bars, we in Leavenworth. Come in and conquer the game, God, I'm on red alert. Living through this hell on earth that we call reality. As we've come accustomed to these fucking abnormalities. Mandates and laws and having a fucking mask on me. No one thinking rationally, they lost the capacity.
No one thinking rationally, they've lost the capacity.
Yeah.
Well, it's 2022, but that hasn't changed.
And this, we know from watching it before, this is going to have a little bit of self-deprecation in it as we get into it. And
yeah.
I sense the first bit of that when we see this kid. The guy has his own personal arcade in his basement. Now, how many people have that? You know, it makes it quite not so bad being locked down in your basement if you got your own personal arcade down there. And a nice little motor scooter, too.
Yeah, well, he's been in the game a long time and he's had some success, so financially he's doing okay. I think he's had some songs going to the millions of views, and so financially I guess he can afford a few little games. And it's kind of funny talking about self-deprecation, we're going to see him on the throne right here.
Free thinker, I'm inevitably labeled a danger as they questioning my efficacy. I'm just here to say whatever I see, stirring up a little vaccine hesitancy. Because celibacy's just the way that I think, cause I don't give a fuck. There ain't no gender fluidity with my dick and nuts. No, not to say that that's a problem, cause it isn't, but don't we have some more important issues to be bringing up?
Yeah, don't we have more important issues than people that think they're gender fluid? I think we do. I think we have a lot of important issues. It's a fad right now. You know, especially young, younger people, you know, to claim that you're a different gender than what you were born with. I mean, very little of that was going on when we were growing up. But now we have a lot of young people that are confused and want to be a different gender than what they were born with. And it's being encouraged, of course, in the culture and in the schools. And, you know, it's causing a lot of problems.
Well, supposedly there'll be a real high suicide rate for some of these people.
There already is. Yeah, there already is a lot of problems. Well,
maybe that's a little unfair because people that have confusion.
But it's gotten to the point
maybe
where
suicide tendency.
The doctors are so afraid of being accused of being, you know, anti-whatever, that if a kid comes to a doctor and says, I think I might be a girl, they put them immediately on these hormone therapy and offer to cut off their dick. I mean, it's ridiculous. But they're so afraid of being, you know, of the cancel culture if they don't go along with it. We're in a really sick place on that.
Give a fuck. There ain't no gender fluidity with my dick and nuts. No. Not to say that that's a problem, cause it isn't, but don't we have some more important issues to be bringing up? I don't know. Coming together against a common foe instead of knocking each other down like we playing dominoes. The World Economic Forum, shit, those fuckers gotta go. And fuck Big Pharma, but I like some of their products though. True. I guess we're all just hypocrites, at least a little bit, even if it's something that y'all rarely ever will admit. But can we throw some self-awareness on the syllabus and hold ourselves accountable? While y'all consider it, I'll call myself out right now and do it gladly. Y'all, they'll never vax me while I snort a 30 milli Addy in a Zanny. So get at me. Say I contradict my own beliefs. Yeah, exactly.
He'll never be vaccinated, but he does like some of those other pharmaceutical products.
Here he admits that his own hypocrisy, and I guess it's inherent in all of us, some hypocrisy like that. You know, we may proclaim some.
We shouldn't let that reference to knocking out the World Economic Forum.
No, I
go
think
by. He said we definitely got to get rid of those people, and I absolutely agree with that. Those people are nuts, and they're causing a lot of problems in this world.
While I snort a 30 milli Addy in a Zanny, so get at me. Say I contradict my own beliefs, yeah, exactly. We all say stuff that conflicts what we do. You could say that I suck, guess what, so do you. There ain't a perfect person that anyone's ever knew, so I'll point this loaded gun at your point of view. How about the kids these days, always holding those phones, like I'm not level 39 on Pokemon Go. I'm a hypocrite, so let me say it again. Type to smoke a couple bogeys on the way to the gym. Yeah, I live like a heathen, got someone I don't really believe in, but ask for his help when I got a reason.
Good point, huh? A lot of people like that don't believe in God until something happens and say, oh God, please help me.
And that's typical. I don't know if it's hypocrisy, I think it's human nature. When a real crisis comes upon the horizon, all our rational talk about God goes out the window, and we're really to embrace the supernatural as some hope. I mean, I think most people are like that. The greatest atheists.
Yeah, they say there's no atheists in foxholes.
Yeah.
Couple bogeys on the way to the gym. Yeah, I live like a heathen, got someone I don't really believe in, but ask for his help when I got a reason. Put up 50 grand last year to protect the animals in an African region, but I'm not a vegan.
Sorry.
Shit, I love a good burger, don't blame me.
Don't.
Even climate change can't change me.
No.
2022, new year, same me, same motherfucking gang, baby, ADHD. Keep the flow fresh while the critics take apart every single word that don't align with what they say is art. Fuck a music chart, my music already made a mark. I'm Megalodon, y'all Duke the Duke, baby shark. So pull them up, go and show my stats. All these years that I've been grinding till I broke my back. My words spark reaction. Shout out to No Life Shack. Haters.
So that little shout out to No Life Shack, who of course is one of the biggest music reactors out there and has, you know, done Chris's songs. But by extension, I think he's calling out all us music reactors, which is nice.
For critics, critics in general.
I think today, the music reactors are kind of like almost the disc jockeys of old.
Or cheerleaders. As critics were sometimes cheerleaders, but it's still, in the broad term of the definition of critic, that's still a critic.
Yeah, we don't do negative reviews. If we don't like a song, we just don't review it.
Well, if there's an aspect, though, we question and stuff.
We might question something here and there, you more than me.
Yeah. Today especially, but yeah.
Today especially, with your interpretation of the system. But, you know, I think actually, you know, having a different point of view is a good thing, because then you got me excited and I get to express myself. In this world, YouTube is so huge, and there's so many reactors, and they're getting so many views, that they really have a lot of influence over what songs become popular, what songs get more views, and what songs don't. So it's a step up from just being a fan. You're a critic, and to a certain extent, you're selecting the songs like a disc jockey of old, before they programmed all the disc jockeys.
Well, I'm kind of surprised that there is really any audience at all for the reactors, but apparently there's a lot. But like you said, back in the day, DJs had their fan base too.
Oh, I love some of the reactors. You know, I'm I'm huge fans. Because they make me smile and they make me happy, and I learn things from them. Like tonight, I'm gonna be busy editing these videos, but if I want to take a break, I'm gonna start watching reactions on Tom's song because I'm really curious to see what other people are gonna say about it.
Yeah. What Webby has injected here is a healthy element of this objective. The other two videos we watched today are absolutely objective. Dylan is talking about the masters of war, these people out there, and system. This is about the system too, but there's a healthy dosage of himself in there, which brings it to an honest level, I guess.
Yeah, it's his personality that's coming through, you know, what he likes, what he doesn't like, and what he doesn't give a shit about.
And sometimes he contradicts himself with his actions, like he says.
And he says, I'm not perfect, and there's nobody on this world that ever was perfect, Jesus.
Saves these animal species, yet he loves hamburgers.
That's the one thing I part company. I'm not a vegan, but I am a vegetarian.
And I don't write back. I'ma take over the map, Connecticut to Iraq. Shit, I'm running for the office of presidency of rap. Kissing baby, shaking hands like a Nintendo Rumble pack. Fuck the competition, never cut them slack. Yeah, I cook them up like Gardy Bucco and serve them with prosciutto. Pushing all the snakes out my circle, I keep it sumo. Do not come around if your deficiency's immuno. I'm the sickest motherfucker you know. Playing every card in my hand till I'm yelling uno. Not a source of news, but all I say is truth though. Let's go, Brandon. Yell it from the roof, yo. Shout to my Canadian fans, but fuck Trudeau.
Yeah, I gotta stop it there because fuck Trudeau. Trudeau is such a wuss and such a tyrant. And I can't believe that the people of Canada haven't rode him out of town on a rail by now.
Yeah. Something I just realized, Chris is like all the rest. He wants to be the best, and he works hard at being the best. And there's this incredible creative, but competitive environment amongst these guys, these rappers. I think it's sort of the same phenomenon we saw in the mid-60s with the bands. This kind of competition, creativity.
There's a lot of competition.
Creates the best art.
Chris doesn't have the following of a Tom McDonald or a Kid Rock, but, you know, pound for pound, his songs really pack a punch.
Right, he might be operating a little deeper intellectual level, too. I mean, this whole idea of just self-deprecation, that's subtle for a lot of people.
And, you know, I think Tom McDonald as well, these are not stupid people that do this kind of stuff. And they read a lot, and they research a lot, and they know what the hell's going on with a lot of issues. You know, they're really leaders in terms of their knowledge of a lot of issues and spreading that knowledge to the people.
I pray that they are having an impact amongst their peers and amongst the whole world because people are hearing this.
This is why I do the reaction videos. We're not in for the money. In fact, not once have I ever asked people to subscribe or to hit the notification button, which most every other guy says about three times at the beginning of every video. We're not in it for that. At least I'm not. I'm in it to hopefully spread the word, spread the message of these great artists to people that maybe, you know, wouldn't have been aware of them without our reaction. Because It's my strong belief that culture is upstream from politics. If you can't change the culture, you're never going to change the politics.
Yeah. And these guys are on that upper
place. These guys are on the cutting edge of changing the culture. And they need all the support they can get. They need to be protected. Now, that thing that happened the other night with Chris Rock being attacked on stage, you saw that?
Yeah, what about Dave Chapelle now?
Dave Chapelle.
That's what you meant, yeah.
Chris Rock was the previous
one. Earlier one, they joked about Will Smith.
But that's horrible. I mean, Dave Chappelle is a national treasure. He's the greatest living comedian in my book. You can argue about some of, Richard Pryor and others that have passed on. But as far as today's comedians, he's the best.
Well, they have given him something to comment on for the rest of his shows, for the rest of his life, though.
Well, he probably will have something to say about it, but
I mean something funny,
a guy could get on stage and tackle him. Like, what if he'd had a knife or a gun?
Yeah.
And apparently he did have a fake gun.
Knife. No, he had a real knife, though.
A real knife and a fake gun.
Which was kind of weird. He must have been wanting to get shot.
Yeah. But that's all connected, to people like Dave Chappelle and Chris Rock and Tom McDonald, who tell the truth about our society, they are in danger. I mean, someone who doesn't like their message might tackle them on a stage or worse.
But if you listen to MSNBC or CNN, they encourage that kind of behavior.
They're encouraging that type of behavior. They want them to attack or kill a Supreme Court justice now because they don't like the potential of Roe v. Wade being overturned. And I've heard the Supreme Court justices have gone into hiding now, some of them, because of death threats. So we live in a very sick society, but we need to support people like this that are willing to stick their neck out and tell the truth.
Well, would you put it past the Democrats to assassinate all the Republican members of the Supreme Court so the new ones could be Biden appointees?
I'm not going to say all Democrats would do that, but the effect of some of the propaganda and vitriol that the exchange is you get a weak link somewhere, some guy, you know, that takes all that message to heart and goes out and gets a gun and tries to kill somebody. I mean, you already had that incident that happened at the softball game of the congressional Republicans were having a practice and some guy showed up with a gun. Thankfully, he didn't kill anybody, but he shot about three or four people. And that was the same type of thing. The thoughts that, you know, that are in the culture give rise to these weak links who get influenced and might go out and do something stupid.
Gold Brandon, yell it from the roof, yo. Shout to my Canadian fans, but fuck Trudeau, I'm Cujo. And you can never tie me on a leash. I'm that shadow band bandit, they can't silence what I speak. No.
I have to stop it again, because I love that line. I'm a shadow band bandit, you can't silence what I speak. Hey, I know the feeling, Chris. I'm shadow banned all the time on Facebook, and hopefully not on YouTube, but that could happen too. So I know that feeling of being shadow banned, but you know, you just gotta keep telling the truth. You can't let that stop you.
You can never tie me on a leash. I'm that shadow band bandit, they can't silence what I speak. No. Fuck a tyrant, I'm a beast. I'm a giant, hit the sirens when I slide up on the beats. Then like ivy on the trees, see them numbers growing up and all without a deal. Living proof that there gonna always be a market for the real. Motherfuck the algorithms trying to target how you feel. Fuck your partisan arguments, I'm the hardest on the field. And I-
that little segment there is an example of what you were talking about the competitiveness of the whole rap game.
It's still important.
And like, so they have to boast, you know, my numbers are going up, you know.
But I think it's very tolerable because if it's creating this atmosphere of creativity itself. I mean, we saw that, like I said, in the mid-60s. With
yeah, it's Stones like the Beatles and the Beach Boys Dylan, are going back and forth with their albums trying to top each other.
Yeah, and what a you know, it fertilizes the whole art.
Yeah. It's almost every rapper, not in every song, but they're going to have a song every now and then.
He's looking to demolish all his competitors with this one piece.
Yeah, like I'm the best. You know, that's the message.
Fuck the algorithms trying to target how you feel. Fuck your partisan arguments, I'm the hardest on the field. Then I hit another three-pointer from the half court. Nothing but some net, I don't even hit the backboard. Rap game vet, here to give them what they ask for. Till I get whacked by a CIA task force. Cause they know the way I flip on wax and kill all rappers. Yeah, I never miss on that. Wednesday before last, but we still on track. It's 2022, bitch. Webby Wednesday's back.
It's like a party. And he talks about Wednesday, Webby Wednesday, because traditionally he releases his songs on a Wednesday. And this just came out this past Wednesday. So it doesn't have a lot of views yet. Just only a few people have reacted to it.
But here again, it's just like he started. It looks to me like it's in his basement, low ceiling, the thick beams. He's really not too deprived. He's got these big parties going on in his millions. That's, you don't feel too bad for him.
Well, somebody wrote in to our other Webby video, and they're like, hope to see you at the next East Coast tour. And I wrote back, and I said, yeah, I would go see Webby. You know, as long as they don't require a vaccination to get in, which I can't imagine he would go anywhere that had that kind of a rule. It's been a long day. You had car trouble.
Yeah, luckily minor car trouble.
We started late and we were interrupted briefly, but we got three done. Good way to end the day on Chris Webby.
Yeah, and it was my favorite video of the day.
You like that the best?
Yeah.
Well, it's hard to beat Masters of War.
I think it's aged.
You think it's aged?
Yeah.
I don't at all. When I watched that, it was like, that's today. Maybe not totally the military part of it, but the warfare we've been involved in.
Yeah, our disagreement may only be of our definition of masters. I might call these other ones masters of mind rather than masters of war.
But it's a war for your mind.
They're diabolical.
Oh, they're, yeah.